His God is trustworthy. His God tells the truth. He keeps his promises. Honesty is part of his code of conduct. People can always depend on him. His God is loyal. His God is true to his family, friends, scout leader, school, nation, and world community. His God is helpful. His God is concerned about other people. He willingly volunteers to help others without expecting payment or reward. A scout is friendly. A scout is a friend to all. He is a brother to other scouts. He seeks to understand others, respects those with ideas and customs that are different from his own. A scout is courteous. A scout is polite to everyone regardless of age or position. He knows that good manners make it easy for people to get along together. A scout is kind. A scout understands that there is strength in being gentle. He treats others as he wants to be treated. He does not harm or kill anything without reason. A scout is obedient. A scout follows the rules of his family, school, and troop. He obeys the laws of his community and country. If he thinks these rules and laws are unfair, he tries to have them changed in an orderly manner rather than disobey them. A scout is cheerful. A scout looks for the bright side of life. He cheerfully does tasks that come his way and tries to make others happy. A scout is thrifty. A scout works to pay his own way and to help others. He saves for the future. He protects and conserves natural resources. He carefully uses his time and property. A scout is brave. A scout can face danger even if he is afraid. He has the courage to stand for what he thinks is right, even if others laugh at him or threaten him. A scout is clean. A scout keeps his body and mind fit and clean. He goes around with those who believe in living by these same ideals. He helps keep his home and community clean. And finally, a scout is reverent. A scout is reverent toward God. He is faithful to his religious duties. He respects the beliefs of others. With the bridge now complete, these scouts are ready to cross over to the next stage of their scouting journey. And Boy Scouts, the parish role becomes diminished as the boys work to develop their independence and leadership skills, but the parents are always necessary to provide support and encouragement. I ask that one parent please join their scout as they cross the bridge to Boy Scouts. Now the boys will receive On the other side of the bridge, they'll receive their epaulets, green epaulets to go on their shoulders, and they will receive their Boy Scout handbook, and they will also receive their new troop numbers. Kevin, will you remove Cooper's handkerchief and accompany him across the bridge? Chad, I remove Luke's handkerchief and come in across the bridge. Also, we will remove Nathan's handkerchief and accompany him across the bridge. James, remove JJ's handkerchief and accompany him across the bridge.
Me.
Heather.
There's no Mason's neckerchief. You wrote Tom's handkerchief and dumped it across the bridge. Scoutmaster Ferg, I'm happy to present these 7 Rebel Scouts for you as new members of your troop. Do you have any final words or thoughts for them and their families?
Welcome the boys, and also welcome the parents to our troops. Just so everybody knows, this is our 60th consecutive year as a registered scout troop. The patches that the boys received today has got their troop numerals on it, also has a bar. Shows 60 years on the log that our troops have been consecutively. I do welcome everybody to our troop.
Great job, Scouts. I congratulate you. Thank you, parents, for all your support over the years. And we look forward to your continued support as we start a whole new group of adventures in the Scouting. Thank you.